Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm happy to meet you again here in Budapest. And I'm going to present about our education program. So we have to go back 4 years in the history. Probably you remember the first CERSC conference in 2012, as Mrs. Sonja Forward was here from Sweden. And she was taking a presentation about road safety education and education methods, and she impressed me a lot. And after that, we have established a civil organization, because I was working with my team on road safety projects, but on the national level. And so we wanted to do something practical on site too, not only sitting behind a table and writing strategies. So we have established this civil organization called Association for Responsible Mobility. And we have made many outside events in schools and festivals and on company family days. As you can see, almost 20,000 people were taking part on these events. And our mission is to educate people on a friendly way. And I have had a conversation in my city. So I'm living 200 kilometers far from here in a city with 60,000 inhabitants. And I have had a conversation with the mayor that it's great to have building projects, as we are building cycle paths and other infrastructure elements. And we have every time a budget for public relation activities, as a billboard is made and many leaflets are printed, but only with the information that a cycle path will be built here, and the European Union gives this amount of budget, the city gives this amount of budget, and that's all about road safety. And if it's ready, then people cannot, if it's ready, people are not taught to use these new elements. And they have a lot of questions. Why is it built that way? And why is it not built? Why is it not signalized at the intersection, and so on and so on? So we try to force them to spend this public relation budget for road safety education in the city. And what is the main problem on the streets? That there are three participants: cyclists, pedestrians, and car drivers. Probably you know the situation. And people are complaining all the time about the traffic morale. So it's not that good like in Austria, our traffic morale is not that great as in Western European countries, and we are complaining about it. But let me have a short game with you. So please rate yourself, your driving skills from 1 to 10. 10 is the best in your mind. No? Are you ready? So who give 10? 9? 8? Okay, 7? 6? 5? 4? Only 1? 3? Nobody? 2? Nobody? 1? Nobody. 0? Okay. So we have had this survey online. We have made this survey online also with more than 1,000 participants. And here is the average. Our driving capability, our driving skills average is around 7.5. But the average should be around 5, right? So everybody is over the average. Here too. Only a few person showed that he is around 5. And we asked them to raid the traffic morale also. And the average of the traffic morale was 9.9. So, and we was thinking on it that what's the difference between these two numbers? And we saw that it's our ego. So we are thinking all the time that, so I'm a great driver, the problem is not with me, the problem is every time with the other drivers, and only with the other drivers. So they are responsible for all of the problems, not me. And so we think that this difference should be lowered or changed a bit. And what can be the background of this problem? Lack of knowledge or lack of sufficient communication or lack of tolerance. So these three things can cause this problem. So, as I have mentioned, if a new infrastructure element is built, then people have a lot of question after that. So, and I have a daughter with the age of 3, and I have learned from her a lot, because she is not complaining about that. Why is it not built that way? She asks, why is it built that way? Why is it so? You know, why? 10 times in a row. And so adults have the same questions, but they don't ask it. They are living. Okay, we will manage it. We have managed it before. And can it be due to the wrong standards too? So I'm an engineer, but I have a lot of arguments with other engineers on user experience topics. So if a cycle path is built that way, and the users don't understand how to use it, then it can be that it has followed the standards, but it's not good. So you understand me. And it can be that the standards are not following the situation or the 21st century. And we were thinking about how to change this behavior, and as the previous presenters have mentioned already, we have find 3 target groups: children, teachers, and the parents of the children. So, like in the STARS project, and we were focusing mostly on children, because I think that the best teachers for parents are their children. So if my friend is sitting next to me in the car and he doesn't fasten his seatbelt, and I tell him that please fasten the seatbelt, then he can say that, okay, next time, or it's only a very short distance and we don't need it. But if my daughter is sitting in the back seat and she asks my friend, or she asks me, hey daddy, why has he not fastened his seatbelt? Then he should fasten it immediately, and he fastens it immediately, because a child is telling him that he should fasten it. So what type of tools did we use in this small city? The first was a classroom chat and education. So it's me in my former school with the children of 8, with children with the age of 8 years. So I like them much, because they are still open for new informations. They like to talk about new things, and we are discussing around 30-40 minutes in the classroom about the traffic signs. For example, for this sign, they are telling it at the beginning immediately that this is a cycle path, and you should build this education from this basis. But at the end, they know that it's not this path is not for cycling. And we are talking about with these signs. And on these days, in the afternoons, we have other programs in the school. So we have a traffic park with signs, traffic lights, and bikes from Valenza Bike. And we are telling them that in the afternoon you should follow the signs you have learned in the morning. So these education is not only theoretically, it's followed by a practical education in the afternoon. Of course, it's not enough to make one day in a year about road safety, but we hope that in the future we will have more money or more options to make such programs. And the other option is to have family days in the weekends. For example, it's in a small sports hall, and there was a festival outside, and we have made the traffic park inside, and around 300 people were taking part on this event. The fourth tool is useful gifts, and I think that a pen and a cup with the National Road Safety Program logo is not a useful gift for children. So we were giving them safety vests and safety armbands. For example, this school is in the suburban area, and many students have to cycle every day outside the city, only 200-300 meters outside the city. But in Hungary, if you are cycling outside the city, you have to wear a safety vest. And many families didn't have the safety vest for children before. So we gave all the participants one safety vest and safety armbands. And I think the most important phase was a follow-up. Of course, the teachers were in the classroom as we were having education with the children, and on that day they have taken part on the practical event, and probably on the weekend they were coming with their parents to the family day, and 2-3 weeks after, the teachers were making the same lecture, or they were talking about road safety, and they gave us feedback about the knowledge or the level of the knowledge of these school children. So they have told us about the leaks, so what was clear that time as we were there, and what they have forgot in 2-3 weeks. And using these feedbacks, we have made brochures and leaflets for local problems. So if the children have no information, not enough information about a one-way street in the city center and how to use the cycle path there, then these informations were involved in these leaflets. One leaflet was made for children with age between 6 and 10, and the other one was made for their parents, and these leaflet for parents was spread out in bike stations, or so how to say, what's the name of the shop where you can buy bikes, or bike stores. So and parents are going to the bike store in every month to repair something, to buy something new, and so they got these leaflets there. And here are the results of this short project. So it was only a pilot project in my city, but we could visit more than 20 classes, and we have made two family events in the sports and in the sports hall, and we have had almost 10 interviews with teachers, and we can implement these leaks and new informations in the leaflets, which were printed in 2000 pieces also for children and also for their parents. So I've tried to be short, not to lengthen this second session and to have lunch on time. But if you have questions for this topic, then I'm happy to answer it now or during the lunch session.